Bobcat Skid Steer was sitting upright in 27 feet of water, approximately 520 feet from shore. It was silted up on one side to its pivot arm and to the top of the cage on the other. Air temperature was approximately 15 degrees with a slight breeze and overcast conditions with intermittent snow flurries. Water temperature at the surface was 34 degrees and at depth was 37 degrees.
I can't. Everything's froze up. I have no steering. I have nothing.
We're turning.
We're going.
There we go. And once I get to rolling, then I'll be okay.
Yeah.
It's like barefoot.
But today, 14-foot long with a 9.9, salvaging the 25-foot deep diver. Is this what you call a specialty dive operation?
Yeah.
Perfect along for the ride.
The day before the recovery, Seal and Chris Lee located and then marked the skid steer with a pelican float. The next order of business was to get Merle to secure the deep diver to the skid steer with a line.
Okay.
Who's running the tank?
You want just one rope, right, Gary?
Huh?
One-to-one, like
yeah. Until we get them full.
We use 55-gallon plastic barrels, each having a lift of approximately 450 pounds. The barrels were ferried out to the site with a 14-foot boat. They were then filled with water and lowered to the skid steer. Each barrel, after it was attached, was partially filled with air from an extra scuba tank. After 10 barrels had been attached, more air was added to each barrel until the suction was released and it floated to the surface. Once the skid steer was on the surface and secured to the cable, the deep diver was pulled to shore. The 14-foot boat then pulled the skid steer in line with the axis so it could be pulled to shore also.
Yeah.
Are you the one that wrote it down?
No, I...
Steering the motor because that barge don't have a steering wheel on it, it's just one of them.
It's not the way that you say it when you do those things to me. It's more the way that you mean it when you tell me what will be. And when you stop and think about it, you won't believe it's true that all of